Part of the reason for this film was to show people exactly what a border wall would go through and how ludicrous the whole idea really is.
So after about 2 weeks of shooting in the field, I came back with our production drives and we started trying to import it all into Premiere. And it was taking an extremely long time. And we decided, what if we just tried to bring some of this into Resolve to look at it? And we were able to do in Resolve in 3 hours what was taking us almost 3 weeks to do in Premiere. Resolve is advantageous for finishing on this film because we're finishing 4K HDR. It's important for us to maintain as much image quality and metadata throughout the entire process of post-production and not lose any of that anywhere along the way.
A friend of mine, Robbie Carman, who is a colorist, got us in touch with the folks behind Jellyfish and encouraged us to take a look at a collaborative workflow using the Jellyfish. What the Jellyfish really afforded us was the ability to have more than two or three people on our shared storage at one time.
So being able to have multiple parts of the project open across different machines has made my job a lot easier, and honestly, the editor's job a lot easier because I'm able to go ask him what he plans to work on next and then prep up timelines, sync up all of that footage, that day's worth of footage for him. So when he's done cutting on what he's cutting, he can move on to the next thing. I can already have everything synced up and everything ready for him.
It was really actually very, very helpful in the director being able to express his ideas and to show what it was that he was thinking, ideas that he had in mind, things that he wanted to try, and then that we could then incorporate into the entirety of the production. If we hadn't had the Jellyfish and that collaborative workflow, that ability to share media across multiple platforms, we would have had a really difficult time in wrangling all of the many moving parts that were part of this production.